Counterpoint, the general knowledge music quiz, chaired by Paul Gambaccini.
Hello, welcome to the grand final of the 2024 Counterpoint Tournament. For the past 3 months, we've challenged contestants from all across the UK with questions on music in all its genres. Our three finalists have more than earned their places here in front of an enthusiastic audience at London's Radio Theatre. A handsome engraved silver trophy awaits our winner today. Let's meet our Counterpoint finalists.
Hello, I'm James Bingham. I'm from Stockport, now living in County Wicklow in Ireland. And the record at number one when I was born was Shakespeare's Sister with Stay.
Hello, my name's Annie Hodkinson. I'm from King's Winford in the West Midlands. And the record that was number one when I was born was A Woman in Love, sadly not by Barbara Streisand, but by Frankie Lane.
Hello, I'm Anju Sharda from Hertfordshire. And the song that was at number one when I was born was Where Do You Go To, My Lovely, by Peter Sarsted.
Welcome back, all three of you. The rules for the final are the same as in every contest you've competed in and won in order to get here. 2 points for your getting your own question right in the opening round, 1 bonus point if you pick up someone else's. In the words of the rock band Europe, it's the final countdown as we start the contest with you, James Bingham. In his 150th anniversary year, which Russian composer's symphonic dances was the most performed composition of all classical works in 2023?
Dvorak?
I'm sorry, he's not Russian.
Oh.
And Anju Sharda would like to pick up.
Tchaikovsky?
And it's not Tchaikovsky. Annie Hodkinson, would you like to name a Russian composer?
No.
Well, I'll therefore have to say Rachmaninoff. Annie Hodkinson, here's your own. Rachmaninoff also achieved the second spot in those statistics for this work performed here by Yuja Wang and the LA Philharmonic. Which of his numbered piano concertos is this?
Plump for three.
And you'll get 2 points. Anju Sharda, a new musical premiered in London in November 2023. Written and directed by Ben Elton, Close Up tells the story of which real-life working-class teenager from Neasden who found fame in the modeling industry?
Twiggy?
Yes, for 2 points. James Bingham. Ben Elton is also known for writing the musicals We Will Rock You and Tonight's the Night. In his early career, he co-wrote the TV sitcom The Young Ones. Here's one of the cast of that 1980s series performing in a very different role. Can you name this actor?
Cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, because you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there, I tell you.
Rick Mail?
I'm sorry, it was not Rick Mail. And Anju Sharda says
Nigel Planer?
And she's right. That song is Mr. Cellophane from the musical Chicago, with Planer playing Amos Hart. Annie Hodkinson, the American composer and musician Richard Lewis Holler, was born 90 years ago this year. He's best known for writing the song Abraham, Martin, and John, which Marvin Gaye popularized in the UK. The song is a tribute to the memory of 4 icons of social change, 3 of whom are mentioned in the title. Which politician is mentioned in the 4th verse?
Hang on, let me just see. He says Bobby, so I presume Robert Kennedy.
And that's how you get 2 points. Anju Sharda, here's a short work for orchestra written in 2005 by the Mexican composer Arturo Marquez. Which dance and rhythm style is celebrated here? I'm sorry, that was not a samba, and James Bingham thinks it's...
Tango?
No, it's not tango. Annie.
It sounded like a conga to me, but I don't think that's true.
Hey, don't sell yourself short. It was conga for a bonus point. James Bingham, in 2023, Barbie's success at the box office led to three songs from that movie reaching the top five of the UK charts at the same time. Tracks by Billie Eilish, Dua Lipa, and Nicki Minaj were part of a soundtrack curated by a British-born DJ and record producer who also wrote the film score and co-wrote the closing song, Dance the Night. What's his name?
Mark Ronson.
That's right. Annie Hodkinson. With International Women's Day on March the 8th, it seems fitting to pay tribute to a woman who changed the sound of British TV and radio broadcasting, my dear friend Annie Nightingale, who passed away in January. Over the years, she interviewed many rock personalities. Here's one now, whom Annie spoke with in the 1980s. Can you identify her?
But I think it takes immense bravery to write about real emotions.
It depends how selfish you are, really. When you get down to real emotions, I didn't feel I had any, but they're slowly coming out as I'm starting to mature, I feel. And my inhibitions are breaking down very fast.
Toya Wilcox?
That was Toya Wilcox, for 2 points. Anju Sharda. In 2023, another new musical, this time by the hip-hop dance company Zoonation, received 3 Olivier nominations. The show, which premiered at the Old Vic, is based upon the life of the woman Zoonation describe as the feminist, activist, pacifist, socialist, rebel, and lesser-known Pankhurst at the heart of the suffragette movement. What's her name, which is also the title of the musical?
Sylvia.
That's right, Sylvia, daughter of Emmeline. James Bingham, we're dipping into the BBC archives again for this alternative version of an educational work by Benjamin Britten, performed on Radio 3 by the Scottish bandleader Duncan Lamont in 1979. You're going to hear the introduction to his suite of variations with narrator, based on a theme by Purcell. Bearing in mind, Lamont was a jazz man, by what name is this work known?
A Young Person's Guide to the Big Band?
I'll give you 1 point, but a bonus point will go to someone who can get the precise title, which no one can do. It's The Young Person's Guide to the Jazz Orchestra.
Oh,
Annie Hodkinson, 2024 is the 80th anniversary of the birth of Joe Cocker, who died in 2012. The Sheffield-born singer's first album featured a recording of the Beatles with a little help from my friends, which brought him to near instant stardom. Another career highlight was his recording of Up Where We Belong, a duet with Jennifer Warnes, for which 1982 film?
Was it Officer and Gentleman?
It was, for 2 points. Anju, we stay with films for the final question of this round as we visit a world of pure imagination. Wonka is a 2023 musical fantasy directed by Paul King, who uses some songs by British composers Leslie Bricusse and Anthony Newley from the original 1971 film Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. Gene Wilder took the lead role in that movie, but who takes it here?
Come with me and you'll be in a world of pure imagination. Take a look and you'll see into your imagination. We'll begin with a spin, traveling in the world of my creation.
Timothy Chalamet.
It is Timothy Chalamet. And it is not your imagination. These really are the scores at the end of the first round. In third place with 3 points, it's James Bingham. In second place with 7 points, it's Anju Sharda. And leading with 9 points, Annie Hodkinson. Now I'm going to give our finalists a list of musical categories or themes from which they'll choose one each and will answer their own set of individual questions. As always, they're hearing this list for the first time. Here are today's choices. Tim Rice and his amazing Technicolor collaborations. The Life of Leonard Bernstein. Streisand at the Movies. Pop on the London Underground. And Beethoven's People and Places. You choose in the order of your scores at this point. So, Annie Hodkinson, you're in the lead. What would you like?
Streisand at the Movies.
And for you, Anju Sharda?
Pop in the Underground.
And that leaves three for James Bingham, which are Tim Rice and his amazing Technicolor collaborations, The Life of Leonard Bernstein, and Beethoven's People and Places.
Leonard Bernstein.
Remember, we don't pass the questions around for bonus points in this round. We start with you, James Bingham, and your questions on The Life of Leonard Bernstein. Directed by and starring Bradley Cooper, what's the title of the 2023 American biographical film which explores the relationship between Bernstein and his wife, Felicia Montalegre?
Maestro.
Yes. Bernstein's ballet, Fancy Free, which premiered in 1944, depicts three sailors arriving in the Big Apple. It was the basis for this musical, which I'd like you to name.
On the Town?
On the Town. You heard Frank Sinatra, Gene Kelly, and Jules Mitchum from the 1949 film version with music by Bernstein, book and lyrics by Betty Comden and Adolph Green. In the late 40s, Bernstein also composed his symphony number 2, The Age of Anxiety. The piece for orchestra and solo piano is titled after whose eponymous poem?
W.H. Auden.
Correct. Based on Voltaire's 18th century story, Bernstein's operetta Candide was first performed in 1956 with a libretto by Lillian Hellman. The soprano Barbara Cook played Cunegonde, becoming renowned for her interpretation of an aria often used as a standalone soprano showpiece. After you've heard it, please give me its title.
Can the brightest brooch shield me from reproach? Can the purest diamond purify my name? And yet, of course, these trinkets are endearing. Ha-ha! I'm awesome that my sapphire is a star. Ha-ha! I rather like a 20-carat earring. Ha-ha! If I'm not pure, at least my jewels are.
That's the fabulous Glitter and Be Gay.
Is that a request? It is Glitter and Be Gay. Bernstein's Chichester Psalms were commissioned for Chichester Cathedral in 1965. The second setting is heard over the end credits of Maestro, with the boy solo performed by Malachi Bayo, singing with the London Symphony Orchestra. Which numbered psalm is this? I'm sorry, it's number 23. Over the course of his distinguished career, Bernstein has received many awards, including 16 Grammys. His score for West Side Story is often performed as a set of symphonic dances arranged as a concert work. The work traces the story of the musical, including a showpiece dance, which demands members of the orchestra to shout out its name. Which word is that?
Mambo!
Correct, for 2 points. And so, James Bingham, in that round, you got 10 points added to your previous 3. You now have 13 points. Anju Sharda. We're going pop on the London Underground, featuring saxophone from Raphael Ravenscroft and guitar by Hugh Burns. Which Jerry Rafferty song shares its name with a station?
Baker Street.
Yes. Let's head west on the Bakerloo line to hear some music. Can you identify this artist and song?
She's Welsh. Mm. Oh, it's gone.
It's Duffy and Warwick Avenue. We journey back to Baker Street, then take the Jubilee line to London Bridge Tube Station. Here we find Carter, the unstoppable sex machine, whose song, The Only Living Boy in New Cross, parodies The Only Living Boy in New York, written in 1969 by which major American recording artist?
Paul Simon.
That's right. In the 60s, the British songwriter Ray Davies composed Waterloo Sunset for his band The Kinks. Here's his performance of the song 45 years later with the London Symphony Orchestra and Urban Voices Collective, marking which event?
Terry meets Julie, Waterloo Station, every Friday night. But I am so lazy, don't want to wander, I stay at home at night. But I don't feel afraid.
Coronation of King Charles.
Oh, I'm sorry, that was from the closing ceremony of London's 2012 Olympic Games. From Waterloo, we head along the Northern Line, where Suggs awaits our arrival at a tube station. As he explains in his 1995 hit single, there's a string of Irish pubs as far as you can see, Greek, Indian, Chinese, or would you like a cup of tea? Which station is that?
Camden.
Camden
Town?
Yes, Camden Town for 2 points. As we enjoy the atmosphere of Camden Town, we hear a 1983 hit from a group who take their name from the longest line on the Underground. Can you name them and the song originally popularized by Nat King Cole?
And while we spoke of many things, fools and queens, this he said to me, the greatest thing you could ever.
Metropolitan.
I'm sorry, it's the Central Line. And do you know the song? Nat King.
Play Misty? Oh, no,
it's not Play Misty for me. It's Nature Boy.
Oh, of course, yeah.
And in that round, you scored 6 points, added to your previous 7, and you also now have 13 points. Annie Hodkinson. Let's see Streisand at the movies. 2023 is the 40th anniversary of an American romantic musical drama directed, co-written, and co-produced by Barbara Streisand, in which her character disguises herself as a man in order to enter a Jewish religious school. What's its one-word title?
Yentl.
That's right. Music now from Funny Girl, for which Streisand won her first Best Actress Oscar. After you've heard Don't Rain on My Parade, I'd like you to tell me which famed comedy entertainer of the early 1900s she portrays on the screen.
Don't tell me not to live, just sit and putter. Life's candy and the sun's a ball of butter. Don't bring around a cloud to rain on my parade. Don't tell me not to fly, I simply got to. If someone takes a spill, it's me and not you. Who told you you're allowed to rain on my parade?
She played Fanny Bryce.
That's right, 2 points. Streisand was Oscar-nominated again for her role as Katie Morosky in the 1973 film The Way We Were, directed by Sidney Pollack. The title theme was composed by Marvin Hamlisch with which successful husband and wife songwriting team?
No, I don't know that.
And the answer is Streisand's dear friends, Alan and Marilyn Bergman. Yep. Here's Barbara singing the Academy Award-winning song Evergreen from the 1976 version of A Star Is Born. In the film, Streisand plays Esther, who during an intimate moment in studio performs the song for rock and roll star John Norman Howard. After you've heard it, I'd like you to name the singer and actor who plays him.
You and I.
Kris Kristofferson.
That's right. Awards and nominations continued for Streisand. This track features on a movie soundtrack recording, but unusually wasn't included in the actual film. The story involves a troubled man who falls in love with a psychiatrist played by Streisand. After you've heard Places That Belong to You, I'd simply like you to name the film.
We learn to fly.
Is it The Prince of Tides?
Yes, it is, for 2 points. Your final question in this round, featuring the songs Dancing and Love is Only Love, in which 1969 film does Streisand play a matchmaker?
Hello, Dolly.
Yes, that's right. And let's say hello to your score, Annie Hodkinson, for in that round you have scored 10 points. Added to your previous 9, you now have 19 points. After the individual round, here are the scores. In a tie for second with 13 points, James Bingham and Anju Sharda. And our leader with just one round to go with 19 points, Annie Hodkinson. It's on the button in the quickfire final round. Things can change quickly. A correct answer wins you 1 point, but you lose a point if you flash in and fail to answer correctly. There are no bonuses. Fingers poised, here we go. According to Hot Chocolate's 1982 hit, it started with a... Andrew?
Kiss.
Yes. Badly Overdrawn Boy, The Folky, and Frugal Sharky are characters from which British adult spoof comic... Andrew?
Viz.
Yes, it's Viz, based on a Shakespeare play, which Nikolai opera begins with two married women discovering they've both received love letters from the nobleman Falstaff. James Bingham.
The Merry Wives of Windsor.
Yes. David Jacobs, Noel Edmonds, and Jules Holland have all presented which pop music panel show? James Bingham.
Never Mind the Buzzcocks?
No. That's a little recent for David Jacobs and Noel Edmonds. It's Jukebox Jury, minus one. Which song did Ingrid Bergman ask Dooley Wilson to play in a classic 19... And Annie says...
As Time Goes By.
Right, from Casablanca. Which Swedish folk group share their name with a small box, usually containing... And Andrew says...
First Aid Kit.
Yes. Which Irish-American dancer and producer is famous for the shows Riverdance, Lord of the Dance, and Annie says...
Michael Flatley.
And gets the point. Elphaba and Glinda are lead characters, and James says...
Wicked.
For the point. Which actor and singer who died in January 2024 had the number one singles Don't Give Up On Us and Silver Lady, Andrew?
David Soul.
Yes. Act one of which Gilbert and Sullivan comic opera begins on a British warship at anchor off Portsmouth, James?
HMS Pinafore.
You are correct. Which series of engravings by Hogarth inspired a Stravinsky opera of the same name? James?
The Rake's Progress.
Correct. Held annually since 1956, which award ceremony is named after a Welsh actor, dramatist, singer, and composer? and I hosted it for 34 years. I feel pretty small right now. It's the Ivor Novello Awards. Oh. The American singer Harry Belafonte, who died in 2023, popularized which style of Caribbean music, James?
Calypso.
Yes. On a normal 88-key piano, how many black keys are there? And no one wants to guess. 36. And finally, which ABBA song begins with the line, I don't want to talk about things we've gone through. James?
The winner takes it all.
And that is correct. Let's see which winner does take it all as I reveal the scores at the end of a thrilling final. Third with 17 points is Anju Sharda. Runner-up with 18 points is James Bingham. And our winner with 21 points is Annie Hodkinson. So, Annie Hodkinson is our new musical mastermind and becomes the 37th BBC Counterpoint Champion. Please step forward to receive the shining silver trophy with many congratulations.
This is a complete shock. really, really never even thought I'd get through the first heat, but this is lovely. Thank you very much for being a lovely audience. And thank you to James and Andrew for being wonderful contestants. And I'm just going to have a drink now.
If you'd like to be a contestant in a future series, email counterpoint@bbc.co.uk or click on the Contact Us link on the program's web pages. We'll make sure we get in touch when we're recruiting for the show again later this year. The scripts for the 2024 series of Counterpoint were devised by Stephen Garner, and the contributing question setters were Alyssa Mattinson and Lillian Crawford. My thanks to them, to our sound engineers across the series, and to producer Paul Bajoria. Until we return, from our new champion, Annie Hodkinson, and all of us here at Counterpoint, goodbye.